with God included in that community as its prime sustainer and its most glorious inhabitant. So I say to us this morning that we need to be mindful of the language we use. There is a challenge here, the challenge of language. As we seek to inculcate that inclusive community, we must face the challenge of language. In many contexts in our society, God is still a he. In many communities, in many gatherings, God is still a he. And we still talk of freshmen. Freshmen. So in our psyche, we're still thinking men. We're not thinking plurality. And we need, that's what I'm challenging us to begin to think, what can we say? Dr. Waigwa, what do you want us to say? Instead of saying freshman. Fresh person, maybe, I don't know. Tell me what we need to say. Come up with something that's more inclusive than freshman. As we seek to create an inclusive community, exclusive language and images may result in individuals feeling that they are not valued and that they are not seen as productive members of the community. But the diversity of Wiley College community should be reflected in our language. And by that I mean that we need to avoid bias when we are speaking or even writing our papers. Oftentimes we see ourselves lapsing into what I would call lazy terminology that excludes women. We just don't want to exercise our mentality a little bit and be creative in our thinking so that we can come up with more inclusive language. So, as I hurry towards the finish, I would say that using inclusive language in the area of culture, race, ethics, ethnicity aims to acknowledge and positively reflect on diversity of our staff, our faculty, and our student population. You see why the community is diverse and it comprises many cultural backgrounds and experiences, and therefore it is important that this diversity be reflected in all the facets of our college life, including in the way we use our language. Language may create an image that people are inferior by being positioned as different to others. Language could also exclude some people from feeling that sense of belonging that is important, integral to any community that we are seeking to create. So it is easy to inadvertently convey and reinforce stereotypic attitudes and assumptions and inaccurate information about various groups of people by using inappropriate language or even terminology. So what's your suggestion, Doctor? I suggest that we inculcate socially inclusive, gender neutral language. Now mark my words there. Socially inclusive, gender neutral language. That's a challenge. I'm not saying we are there. We're not there yet, but we have to work on it. I want to suggest that our intelligent conversations here at Wiley must avoid language that would universalize one element of humanity. For example, maleness, blackness, whiteness, to the exclusion of all others. May we learn to use socially inclusive language. Socially inclusive language, how does it look like? It does not single out one person's sex or race or ethnicity, or even personal traits or characteristics such as sexual orientation, their age, their weight, their disability. Somebody said people's age and weight is none of your business unless you're their doctor. So these are things we need to avoid. In other words, we don't want to create stereotypes based on unavoidable human characteristics. So if we all use this kind of language that I'm suggesting, socially inclusive, gender neutral language, we will create right here at Wiley an environment that promotes respect and values diversity. By using this kind of language, the church that Jesus bought on the cross of Calvary will begin to happen right here. We will become a microcosm of the Church of Jesus Christ. We will become a microcosm of the great American spirit that is captured in this Latin phrase, e pluribus unum, out of many, one. So finally, how can we develop this language? I'm glad you asked. Because I would like for you to tell me, I'm just still thinking about it. How can I? Because I still find myself talking of God as He. How can I develop this? But I go to a man called David Shibler, a scholar in this country, who's written a beautiful book called A Country of Strangers. He gives us these three recommendations that I will leave you with. He says that we need to search our attitudes. Number one, search your attitudes. And then identify your stereotypes. Don't say you have no stereotypes. You do. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves. You do have stereotypes. Search them and identify them. And then he says, correct. Do your own corrections about your those stereotypes in your daily duties. He suggests that we need to reconstruct our own thought patterns and resist those social gender stereotypes. In other words, every time I refer to God as He, I want to very quickly come back and erase that in my conversation and say, excuse me, I mean God. When I say He, and then I'm talking about the eternal God of glory, and I'm seeing Him as a man, I will come back and say, no, I'm talking about God, the creator of heaven and earth. When we do so, we are truly, truly going to be a pluribus unum. Heavenly Father, heavenly eternal parent. We know that if we say we have no stereotypes, if we say we have no prejudices, we would be denying, we would be lying to ourselves, and we would be making you a liar because you have said we have sinned. Heal our trespasses. Come and help us to change our language. Help us to choose words that can bless one another. Help us to choose words that can lift our brothers and sisters. Help us to choose words that can build our community. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Is that a great message or what? Let us show appreciation to our very own Dr. Waigwa. I want to announce our international film for today, for this evening. It is the Best Picture of the Year. It won the Academy Award for the Best Picture of the Year, directed by Danny Boyle. It's called Slumdog Millionaire. So please come 7 o'clock in the Student Union. Everyone is welcome. And now I ask everyone to please stand for the alma mater.